Right, hello class, hello viewers. Welcome to Mr. Marashanya Online Lessons. Today I want to teach you about all the laws of indices. All the laws of indices. So I'm going to summarize everything on indices. Remember, these are only basics of indices. These are the things that you are going to remember as you are going to revise and dig deeper on what we call indices. Okay, the first law of indices, which is here, law A, it states that multiplication of same basis, multiplication of same basis. For example, we have base A here, we have base A here, to the power m, of course, for base for the first base, and to the power n for the second base. So if we have same base like this, and while list those numbers are multiplied, what it means is that you have to add the powers. You have to add the powers. So in other words, I am saying multiplication of numbers in indices, it means addition of powers. It means addition of powers. Okay? As you can see in this example A here, you can see that the question here, it says 3 to the power of 6 times 3 to the power of 2. Because the bases are the same, we're going to take only one base, which is 3, as you can see here. And what are we going to do? Because the bases are the same and because these numbers are multiplying, we are going to add the powers. For example, here they leave this stage. They were supposed to write it like this, 3 to the power of 6 plus 2, to show that this multiplication is there to resemble or to show that you must add the powers. Okay? And our final answer will be 3 to the power of 8. Right. Second law, when you divide the numbers, you must subtract the powers. So the difference between the first law and the second law is that the first law says that when you multiply, you add the powers. But second law, it states that when you divide, you subtract the powers. For example, we have this scenario here, 3 again to the power of 6 times 3 to the power of 2. What are we going to do? We have the same basis. Sorry, it's not times here, but it's divide. Let me just erase everything here so that I can show you how to deal with this kind of a problem. Right, as you can see here, you can see that we have 3 to the power of 6 divided by 3 to the power of 2. What are we going to do? We have division. What does division mean in local in indices? It means that you must subtract the powers if the bases are the same. So I'm going to take only one base here, which is 3 to the power of 6 minus, because of this division, minus because of this division, which means the division of numbers in indices, it means subtraction of powers. So I'm going to say minus 2, and our final answer will be 3 to the power of 4, as you can see here, right? I hope you are assisted on that one. Right, moving on to the next area, which is law number 3, which is said that A to the power of 0 is 1. A to the power of 0 is 1. A to the power of 0 is 1. What it means is that any number multiplied, sorry, any number raised to the power of 0 is 1. Any number raised to the power of 0 is 1. For example, if I'm going to have 5 to the power of 0, the answer is 1. 10 to the power of 0, the answer is 1. 1,000 to the power of 0, the answer is 1. But there are different scenarios that I'm going to show you here. If you are going to come across this kind of equation, 5 to the power of 0, yes, the answer is 1. But minus 5 to the power of 0, the answer is not 1, but it's minus 1. And minus 5 bracket to the power of 0, the answer is 1. So what it means is that in this scenario here, this power 0 is only affecting 5. but is not affecting this negative. It's not affecting this negative. That's why I get minus one as the correct answer. So you need to be careful. But when it comes to this one, negative because of bracket show that it multiplies everything. It multiplies everything, which means it's affecting five, is also affecting negative. And we're going to get positive as our correct answer, positive one. Right, moving on to the next area, which is of great importance. A to the power minus n. A to the power minus n. What they are trying to say here. Very good. Could you be say negative always, not one over. Could you be say negative always, not one over. Could you be say negative always, not one over. So, because I'm going to question, I got 5 to the power minus 2. First of all, unofana kuta say, unofana kubisa negative sign. You're going to say 5. You're going to say 1 over 5 to the power 2. Now, without a negative. Because for you to remove a negative, you need to say 1 over. That's it. Those are kuzama kutidisa. Kubisa negative, you say 1 over. Kubisa negative, you say 1 over. Next one. A to the power m bracket n. What it means is that if I'm going to have a situation like this, a to the power of m bracket n, what it means is that these powers, they are multiplying. Why? Because there is a bracket. Bracket means multiplication. So what they are saying here is that a is to the power of m, because of the bracket here, you're going to multiply times n, then you're going to get a to the power of m n. That's why they get this one as the correct answer. Right. And let me check the examples that they gave you here. The example that they gave you. Right on this one, they gave you something like this, which is correct. And most of the time, you have to leave your answer after finding the exact square root, the exact value of 3 to the power of 2. And here, you have to multiply 3 to the power of 5. Bracket 2, you have to multiply this one times this one because of bracket, and you're going to get this one as a correct answer. Here, a to the power 1 over n. A to the power 1 over n. So this law, I can't say anything. Let me use this one so that I can help you to understand this law. Okay? Right. See now. They said 3 to the power 1 over 4 is equal. Then they said the cube root of 3 to the power 1. What it means is that triple the number, you know, multiply 4 times, it should be 3. You know, multiply 4 times, it should be 3. Can I tie 1 to the power 1? Can I tie 1 to the power 1? For example, if you are going to get something like 8 to the power of 2 over 3, what they are saying is triple the number, you know, multiply 3 times, it should be 8. Can I tie 1 to the power 2? No power to the cube root of 8. Can I tie 1 to the power numerator, which is 2 in this case? So number that multiplies itself 3 times to give us 8 is 2. Can I tie 1 to divide to the power of what? 2, which is this one. So we are going to get 2 times 2 is what? 4. Because the 2 to the power of 2, it means 2 times 2. This 2 is multiplying itself 2 times. Right, Dan, I hope you are assisted on that area. Right, moving on to another law, which is the last law. I think it's just the same law. Inotaura kuti iyo ndeipino zvimaplayaka 3 ka 5 ichitipa 3. I don't know. For example, you can come across this kind of equation. They can give you something like 32 to the power 2 over 5 like this. What they are saying is find the fifth root of 32. When you get that, raise it to the power of 2. Let me repeat this. Find the fifth root of 32. When you get the fifth root of 32, raise it to the power numerator to the power 2. So I'm going to do that. The fifth root of 32 to the power numerator 2 in this case. What is the number that can multiply itself 5 times to give us 32? It's 2 to the power of 2. 2 to the power of 2, it means this 2 is multiplying itself 2 times. So it means 2 times 2, which is equal to 4. The last one that I'm going to do quickly is this one. Is this one. 27 to the power 1 over 3. It means the cube root of 27, okay, to the power 1. Number, I know, multiply 3 times, it's 27. It's 3 to the power 1, which is 3. Done.